Hi everyone, this is Usha Pandit, your Mindsprings English teacher. Today we are going to talk about spoken and written English. Now, English is not our native language, so we are bound to make some mistakes in it, and that's natural. But very often when a large population speaks in a certain way, we are not even able to detect the errors, and that is the problem. Now, the bigger problem is that when students write in the same English as they speak, and which is accepted because so many other people are speaking it, they get poor marks and they are perplexed. A lot of times, teachers have no idea how to change colloquial sentences into good sentences. And I think the first step is to stop speaking those sentences. That's easier said than done. But if you want help in English in writing, do look at my book, Writing with Ease. It's available on Amazon. It's available on our website. And it will give you lots of strategies in writing. So let's begin. Let's look at some very common sentences that you hear all the time. The first one is, I think y'all should come. Now you might say, oh, what's wrong with that? Y'all should come. This Y-O-U and then apostrophe L-L, y'all, is a very, very clumsy construction. Try not to even say it. It's better to say, I think you all should come. Do not put an apostrophe and make it into a contraction. This y'all is an extremely clumsy construction. Don't do it. Just say, I think you all should come. And that's perfect. Okay? So stop that contraction. The first lesson. The second sentence that I hear is, what all she'll say. This what all, or where all she'll go. When all she'll... This is wrong. What all is a terrible construction. Do not say it, it's grammatically wrong. What all she'll say if I'm late. You'll hear people talking like that. Oh my God, what all she'll say if I'm late. It's a terrible construction, don't say it. Instead of that, say, there's no saying what she will say if I'm late. There is no saying what she will say if I'm late. Or you might say, if I'm late, she'll nag me endlessly. That's also good. Change the construction. But this what all she'll say. Or you say, you have no idea what she will say if I'm late. That's fine. Do not do what all she'll say. It's wrong. Okay, so that's the second one. The problem is when you talk like this, you end up writing like this. And if you write like this, it'll be marked wrong. The third one is, if y'all are not going, then we'll also not go. Have you heard this? If y'all are not going, then we'll also not go. What have you done? You've contracted y'all and you've contracted we'll. We, W-E, apostrophe, L-L. Both are wrong. We'll is a terrible construction. Y'all, avoid. So, instead of that, what you need to say, if you are not going, remember that you is a plural you. I am, you are, singular. I am, you are, singular. We are, you are. When I say you, I mean all of you. So, you is both singular and plural. So, if I say, if you are not going, I could mean one person, you. Or it could mean all of you. So there's no need to say y'all. You already is plural. So therefore say, if you are not going, we won't go either. Such a beautiful construction. If you are not going, we won't go either. And that's the correct way to say it. Just practice these things, and whenever you feel like saying this y'all, we'll and all that, stop yourself and say, I'm not going to say that. I'm going to say it the right way. Memorize it if necessary. But do not say, y'all will. Okay? The fourth one is, Why you are not coming? What are we doing here? What's wrong? Why you're not coming? You're not coming is a statement. Why is a questioning word. Why you're not coming with an inflection that goes up to make it a question is completely wrong. Why aren't you coming? Why are you not coming? Both are right. Why aren't you coming? Why aren't you coming? Just say this many times. Your tongue will get acclimatized to saying, why aren't you coming? Why aren't you coming? Why aren't you coming? Why aren't you coming? Do it. And you'll get it. And you won't write the wrong thing when you are writing something for an examination or for an article or whatever. So why aren't you coming? Not why you're not coming. The last one I've got is, when you'll come? When you'll come? Very common. Again, when you will come is a statement. So it should be, when will you come? It's a inversion. You will is a statement. Will you is a question. So when will you come is the correct way to say that. Small, very tiny little five small little things that I've shown you. Check it out and see how many people use this. When they say it over and over again, you think, hey, I mean, that's what I've heard. It must be correct, but it's wrong. So catch yourself saying it, catch your friend saying it and correct it, finish it off. And your writing will automatically change for the better. So I hope you liked that one. Subscribe to our channel. Press the bell notification. And until we meet again, keep smiling.